Hello, everybody. Welcome back. Antonio from Antonio TV here. And today, I am with a special guest, JMan Seminars.
What's up, everybody?
Doing a collaboration.
A little collabo. Collabo is so fabo.
So today's video, we're going to be filming.
I'm hot here on the beach.
Yeah, around the beach. We're going to be filming, or I'm going to be filming, and he's my special guest, of course. 10 things to do during quarantine for the second time, because the first time the audio got corrupted, but it's fine.
So what was the lesson learned from that?
That sometimes YouTube can be a pain in the butt.
Or double check your audio, make sure your microphone's recording.
Yeah, or if you have a Chromebook that has crappy audio. Watch out for that.
Butter microphone.
Yeah, like this.
Butter, yo.
Yeah, butter. Here, can you hear him?
Probably can't hear me as well because I'm further away from the mic, but.
Yeah, it's okay though. You know, out here, boys, in the beach.
All right, so 10 things.
All right, you want to start off?
Oh, I wasn't prepared at all, so.
Well,
you did it yesterday. I thought it'd be easier for you to do it again.
Well, yeah, but there's no audio.
Okay, I got an idea. So maybe doing video?
Yeah, you could. That was one of my things yesterday I had. It was like video expressing yourself in your own way on the internet to other people. Like, for example, YouTube, as I'm doing with my dad. And you could also do Facebook, Instagram, other social medias like that, TikTok platforms, any type of platform where you can, you know, get creative. Our guest has, well,
fixing the lighting.
He's offset for 2 seconds.
I'm back.
Alrighty. So, you want to lead us into the next, or I'll lead us into the next thing. Next thing is spend time with your family. Do family game nights, games, charades.
Yeah, we did charades. That was fun. I didn't want to do it at first, but then it was like totally
Yahtzee, fun. Any other games you have that's fun that can have be a whole family game, you know? You want to listen to number three?
Okay, number three would be get outside.
Oh, I talked about this one too yesterday.
Oh, so I kind of stole your thunder.
This one is all right.
Fred, you want to go? You want me to say?
Yeah, I'll say it.
Okay, go ahead.
Just go outside, get some exercise as long as you're staying safe, wash your hands frequently, keep a mask, gloves, stay 6 feet, social distancing helps save a lot. Yeah. That's number three.
Yeah, and it's important, you know, like choose the park that you know. Like there's some parks that I know that the trails are kind of narrow.
Like Maplewood and
if they're really narrow trails, then like when you see other people, it's hard to get off trail and stay safe.
Yeah, kind of like if you've ever been to Seneca Park, the trail behind there, it's kind of thin and you have to like
some of them are really wide too.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, so lead us into number four, sir. You gave us 10, which is hard. I hate doing numbered things. Then I'm like, I need 10. But what is it? What's the next one?
Well, yeah, number four would be take care of your pets. Spend some quality time with your pet, you know, feed it, cuddle it or something like that. Give it, you know, have some quality time with your pet while you still can before you have to go back to school and leave it at home for 8-7 hours a day while your parents are at work too and she's sitting there home alone in their cage.
She's singing, I'm in the house bored.
Yeah, bored. copyright. Copyright.
So your four was pets. Now it's my turn again.
Alrighty.
Number five, ladies and gentlemen. Number five.
We're halfway through
during a pandemic.
Halfway through it.
How about that hobby that you always wanted to do, but you never had enough time? Maybe you wanted to start knitting or
popcorn
or bird watching
or popcorn
or any number of things.
Cooking.
Oh, cooking's a great one. Cooking. Yeah. So take up a hobby that you never thought you'd have time for before. That's number five.
Number five.
Six.
All right, number six. Now, and then the number six, we're over halfway. So for this one, we could do some, like, you could do, like, you got to stay focused on work, too. During the during a pandemic or the pandemic that we're having, you got to stay in business. You got to, you know, you got to stay focused on your work, keep your financial things up, you know, just stay on track.
Yeah.
Stay on track.
Is that six?
That was six, yeah. All right, you're number seven. I already got my number eight.
Dang, that was really good. Number seven things to do during a pandemic, support a local business. So if you have like a restaurant or, you know, the big box stores, I feel like are going to be okay, but it's the small mom and pop, the local businesses like us, like, you know, our family, we're a small local business being real estate agents in the area, but also the restaurants that are used to being filled with people that can't have people now, or any place that's, you know, a service-based business, you can support them by, because some of them are still doing takeout, some are doing delivery through Grubhub.
Yeah.
And, you know, or purchase gift cards, right? Gift cards could be used. It's a way that you can support the business. They bring in the money and then they can stay open so that you can still have your favorite restaurant once the pandemic ends.
Yeah. Heading into number eight, I'm gonna do it with stay in touch. Stay in touch with your friends, people that you want to stay in touch with, like on like platforms like Messenger Kids, Messenger, Facebook, stuff like that, where we can talk
a little bit about Messenger Kids, because that's a good way that you stay in touch with your friends. You can still get that social aspect.
Yeah.
You don't see
Messenger Kids is an app, basically kind of like Messenger on Facebook that you have, but it's made for only kids and your parents, this lovely person right here, controls who your contacts are. Right. So you can, like, you have a code, right? And you have that code, and the other person has to know that code and then type it in, and then it'll ask permission for your parents to let that person talk to you. So if I knew, let's say, this random person named Jared, and his code was apples.
Does he like Subway?
Yeah. And his code was apples, peanut delivery man. And I would type in that code. He wouldn't become my friend until they verified who he was.
I would get a message saying, this person whose parent is this person wants to connect with your son on Messenger. So make sure that there isn't any creepers out there that are trying to contact you.
Creepy, scary skeletons.
Right.
Shivers. We should
change. All right, so that's eight. That was eight.
You're at number
nine. Number nine. I was like thinking, I'm like, man, I'm glad you took a little bit of time because I had time to think of it. Number nine would be exercise.
Ooh, this is a good one. I had that as number four yesterday.
Oh, you did. Well, it's so important in a time of high anxiety and stress, and everybody's like, I don't know what to expect.
Here, let me get in this a little bit.
I find that,
like, I love, like, primitive things, like primitive builds and all that. I don't know why.
You live, you're a caveman.
But oops, sorry. I like, you can have a workout in your garage as we're trying to build like a little workout station in our garage.
The gyms are closed, so it's like, even for me, some days, you know, it helps so much to go for a run. If I'm get tired of running, or my knees hurt or something like that, I go for a walk or a bike ride, right? Or even just a hike, like any of that, it produces endorphins. Endorphins help you feel better. It's a great way to start your day. It's a great way to start out positive.
Let's have another number nine, because that like workouts kind of ties into getting outside. Like both of them kind of tie into each other.
Not
so
really.
Well, I'm doing a bonus before number 10, the last one.
So you're going to do 9B.
Yeah, 9B. 9A,
and you do 9B.
9B.
Okay.
9B, 9A, and 9B. Stripe one and stripe two. Okay. So 9B is going to be.
Nine. B is gonna bzzz.
I don't know. Let's see. Where to get food? That's where. It's a lot of problem. That's a problem that a lot of people are having. Where to get food? Where do you get food? Well, if you can't go to your local, you know, Wegmans or something like that, you can't go to your local Wegmans.
Maybe you don't want to because there's people there and you want to, you know.
Yeah, you can either go to a smaller business or maybe like the Wegmans block down or like a mile down from that or, you know. Closer to the mic. Maybe a Wegmans in Nebraska. I don't know. Just if you can't get to your local place or you don't want to, you can just go somewhere else. You know,
so get out and get some food, maybe like a farm market or something like that. Get the food fresh. Or this could be 9C, like garden, like plant your own stuff, plant your own food.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what I was saying the other day. I was saying,
I was saying
the other day, kind of tying into what you just said, planting, sort of like getting stuff done around the house, like, you know.
Projects
like decorating or like getting rid of plants and replanting things and, you know, cleaning up the yard and pulling weeds and, you know, just anything really that helps while you're just stuck at home with your family. Alrighty.
Number 10.
Last one.
No. I didn't have a number 10. You had a number 10 that you were going to say. So bring it back to you. Let me see if I can get it.
Oh, back to me. All right, back to me.
hold on.
And the 10th one is... I don't know yet. All that build up for... I don't know yet. Okay.
Did you say videos already?
Yes.
How about I got a 10th one. Doing something that we mentioned already, but do it with a family member.
Ooh,
so video creation like we're doing now.
Yeah.
Going outside and exercising like we're doing, like we do together. We're like, we'll go for walks, we go for bike rides. It's so much better with family. Now you're combining
one of you
the
get,
other nine things.
You also get more
time QT,
to bond.
Man, more
bond time. Bond time.
Well, we got our mom. She's wondering where we're at. But anything else you want to say, kind of?
Well, I hope you enjoyed. I hope this can help you throughout your future for the rest of this pandemic thing or any pandemics in the future, mm-hmm. if we have any. I hope not. I will see you all next time. And thanks for watching. As again, I am Antonio from Antonio GV, and
I am Jeremiah J. Man Monero from J Man Speaks. Come back into the shot here, and let's give
go subscribe
Antonio
to him
a big round of applause. Oh man, I got all. Oh, wait, another round of applause. That's fantastic.
Subscribe to J Man Seminars on YouTube and
Antonio from Antonio TV.
Alrighty, bye.